Welcome to a new test and teardown video. I don't know if this is going to be a repair video as well, but I think I got this one defect, so we're gonna have a look at that. This one is a Fluke 8000A digital multimeter. It is from about 1972 to 1976, so it's actually quite old. I just cleaned this a little bit so we can see this without, you know, it was actually quite nasty, but now it's quite all right. So the 8000A is just a standard multimeter where you select one feature at a time. There is no auto range or anything like that. It's super back to basics, and it is only 3.5-digit LED readouts. It comes with different options, and they're normally written here on the back. And this is actually very important for you to inspect this, what kind of options you got. Especially this, see here in the middle of the picture, it can do 115 or 230 volts. But this one is wired for 230. So that means I can power this up. And also here, the rechargeable battery option is not a thing in this one. And that is good, because I really hate finding old crappy batteries inside the units. And you can also feel the weight. It's really not that heavy. But I want to open this before I start to test it. And it is super easy, only one screw here, and then you pull out the entire case. So now we're inside the Fluke 8000, and it is just beautiful. If you look at previous Fluke products, they're just full of wires and connectors and solderings and do this and do that a million places. And of course, that is very expensive in production. And this is, of course, why they took the step up. Look at this LED display board. It's just a thin PCB that is soldered directly into the main board. Not even a connector that can generate loose connections, but it's soldered directly into the PCB. So this is, of course, solderings down there you need to inspect. No cracks, no nothing, but it's perfectly fine. And this is actually a very good and super cheap method. No wires that can be wrong or be loose or anything like that. And it's just a PCB. Stick it in, solder it, and Barbara's your uncle. I think you should do this on products like this. I've been carefully inspecting capacitors. I don't see any leaks yet. It looks a little bit like this capacitor was changed, because it's not exactly the same solderings as the original solderings. If you look at that capacitor here, you'll see that will be original solderings. So I think those three capacitors here, they were changed at some point. I also like the way that adjustments can be done. See? They wrote exactly what to do here. And then we got some fixed resistors in sockets. That's, of course, also for calibrations and stuff. But it is super nice and clean in a super good state. So yeah, I'm definitely going to power this up. Just took away this little shielded box here. Don't you just love the way that they made this? See those? Ha! This is nice. And they kind of interlock with those holes. Fascinating. So that's just an op amp for the input amplifier or some stuff like that, right? Oh, we got a lot of tantalum. It's always a little bit scary with tantalum capacitors, because they don't have a lifetime of infinity. So they start to leak and stuff, and there's also a temperature thing and just a general lifetime thing. Oh yeah, another thing with those Fluke, and it's all of these. The power entry connector here is very, very funny and special. But I think again they made this design so they can have all on one board. No wires, no nothing, only happiness and easy. Only one screw to assemble with. It's like all the stuff that always was a problem and was driving cost. They just removed all that. One board. Super, super smart. So let's try the first power on. First, we do mains entry, and that is good. I didn't see any. Three point 5 watts. And what do you know? Those are the super, super sexy LEDs, and they're actually made with tiny little LEDs in series. Look at that. Wow, they are nice. Oh. So we are in DC volt, 20 volts range. And here is 4. What do you think about that? Now we'll go through all the different ranges and see if I can find anything wrong. So I'm still playing around with the different ranges or how accurate it is, and then I realize we got a mechanical problem here. It reads really, really good in this range, but that means I can't see. Oh, let me turn off the. See, I can't change the ranges because this switch here is, see, it's not going out. So I need to fix this. The others over here, they're all also a little bit stuck. So this is just old grease that turns into a gum. So I'll have to fix that and then proceed, hopefully. So after a lot of cleaning here, I managed to get all the switches working really, really good. And I know now why the range 20 was the one that goes stuck first. It's because this one is longer and they also put in a spring. I think you can see here there's another color code on that spring, and that is because this spring is tougher. So it will be able to pull out this switch better. And you can even feel it when you push that switch. So it's actually a little bit harder to push. So that means it's also going, you know, a little bit harder towards this lock unlock mechanism that is released when you push some other of the range switches. But as you can see now, they all work. It's all about cleaning. Now I hope it will work in all the different ranges. It's a problem. After cleaning, I now have introduced a problem. Look at that. That range is now really bad and nothing is connected. So there's a leak or something like that. And I think it has something to do with old corrosion of the contacts. Some material is now placed where it's not supposed to be. So I need to go through the cleaning once again and see if I can get this solved. My God, that was probably the most complicated cleaning process ever. I've been through this and repeating and repeating and repeating. And it is, of course, a million times better now, but it's not completely perfect. We're almost there. So we got some tiny little leaks in the switches from all the corrosion and all the old dirt that I've been cleaning out. And it's kind of wandering around from place to place in the switches. What So I'm flushing them with pure alcohol and compressed air, and I'm repeating and repeating until it's completely flushed out. Holy moly, that is difficult. But yeah, it is definitely getting better and better here. I think I'm done playing with this. It is a little bit off, but at least it's working. And this is the highest voltage range. I don't have any more to give from my Fluke tester, so about 1100. So yeah, it seems to be able to handle 1100. So I can just crank it down here. So definitely clean the contacts and do it a million gazillion times until you're happy. That was my day today. Oh, that was terrible. And it stinks in here now.